The new T-7A Red Hawk trainer jets scheduled initial operating capability, IOC, was postponed by the U.S. Air Force, UUSAF, from 2025 to 2028. This is consistent with budget cuts to purchase the trainer jet, which is constructed by Boeing and Saab. In 2018, the USAF initially gave Boeing a contract to acquire the T-7A, and in 2022, the trainer was introduced. The trainer was praised as a digital design pioneer by the USAF and Boeing. However, the aircraft's progress has been hindered by problems with the wings, ejection seats, and damaged parts. Up until now, a number of milestones, including the IOC milestone, have been postponed by technical problems. One of the newest supersonic jet trainers in the U.S. Air Force is the Boeing T-7A Red Hawk, formerly the Boeing TX. The USAF's Air Education and Training Command, AETC, created the trainer in order to replace the Northrop T-38 Talon, a supersonic aircraft. Originally, it was anticipated that the Boeing T-7A Red Hawk program would be finished by 2020. However, the trainer program's operational date was advanced to 2017 because of the 2008 T-38C failure. In February 2021, the Boeing T-7A Red Hawk design went into serial production. Using digital design techniques, the trainer was built in less than 3 years, allowing the USAF to quickly incorporate new, low-cost designs and earn the E prefix, designating it as part of the Digital Century series. With its single engine, twin fins, and stadium seating, the trainer aircraft offers instructor pilots and student pilots an excellent perspective of the cockpit. The T-7A has embedded training, state-of-the-art display systems, and contemporary avionics. From the beginning, the ET-7A was intended to mimic the sophisticated fourth and fifth generation aircraft systems and capabilities, including high G, high angle attack performance, and a combination of onboard and synthetic systems, such as data linkages, intelligent weaponry, defense systems, and simulated radars. The aircraft has next generation AC's 5 ejection seats, flying wire controls, a fully digitalized glass cockpit, stadium seating for better rear seat visibility, a modular system architecture, and an easy-to-maintain design. The Air Force's long-running attempts to alleviate the pilot shortfall will probably be slowed by the IOC delay. The aging T-38 fleet is one of the culprits, according to Air and Space Forces magazine. At least two T-7 prototypes are in service with the USAF right now. One is at Edwards Air Force Base in California, where it is being tested in developmental flight. The other recently finished climate tests at Florida's Eglin Air Force Base.